Very often, celebrities would say no, because Vanity Fair had a very checkered history. Annie's name was the open sesame to so many artists, because they knew that they would get something extraordinary, that she would push them into doing things that they might not be able to do with anybody else.
Hi!
Come to the garden, the mysterious garden!
George, goddammit!
Can't work with
you, young man. Come here.
Oh, I'm good. I'm not even in this shot.
No, yeah.
I'm operating the camera.
You're just on the ground, just like at her feet.
Again?
George, actually, you don't look very comfortable. Do you want to come right on your bottom? Come right on your bottom. Julia, just try your arms out on the. It's fantastic.
Great.
Okay.
Going from Rolling Stone to Vanity Fair, I didn't really have the tools to make people look good. I didn't quite understand there was a good side and a bad side. All that stuff seems silly to me, that people should get dressed up. When you saw Jerry Garcia and he had on his t-shirt, you know, that's, you didn't think, well, hey, maybe you want to put on your, you know, a suit or something.
Here we go, here we go. Hold on, is the fan going? A little bit. Great. George, now move your bottom over a little bit. To your left. Julia, lean your bottom right into the wall there. There you go. And George, your bottom still has to go through. Yeah. And
the cover is kind of a thankless dilemma, because the cover is not a photograph. I mean, you might as well be doing advertising. It really is designed to sell the magazine. And I am put in the position of having to take those pictures. But my work really lives inside the magazine. My real photographs are inside the magazine. There is every now and then a moment where it opens up and you can do the kind of work you really could only dream about doing.